Professor Dave and Chegg here, we just learned how to calculate the pH of strong acid solutions, which was rather straightforward. But when we consider weak acids, things won't be as simple. Let's learn how to do this now.
Let's say we are looking at an aqueous solution of hydrofluoric acid. This is a relatively weak acid with a Ka of 7.2 times 10 to the negative 4. Since this is weak, not all of it will dissociate. Some HF molecules will donate a proton to water to form hydronium and the fluoride anion, while some HF molecules will remain intact. So unlike with strong acids, we can't simply take the HF concentration as being equal to the hydronium ion concentration. Instead, we have to do some calculations. Here is the Ka expression for HF. Let's say we are dealing with a 1 molar HF solution. What will be the pH? Just like with other equilibria, we will have to construct an icebox and use some simple algebra to get to an answer. For the initial concentrations, we have 1 molar for HF and 0 for the product, as this is before any ionization takes place. Then we have 1 minus X, as some HF will react, and given the 1:1:1 ratio, we should put plus X for the other two substances, given that the Ka of HF is such that the hydronium produced will make the hydronium present due to autoionization of water totally negligible. This means the equilibrium concentrations will be 1 minus X, X, and X. Now, if the concentration of a weak acid is at least 4 orders of magnitude greater than the Ka, we can consider the decrease in acid concentration to be negligible. We have such a situation here, where the HF concentration will remain so close to 1 molar that we can simplify things by just calling it 1 molar, as 0.999 molar may as well just be 1 molar. So let's just keep this as 1 molar on the bottom. This means that in order to solve for x, we can simply take the square root of both sides, since we have x squared on the right. This leaves us with x being equal to 0.027. As we can see from the way we constructed the icebox, this is equal to the hydronium concentration. So we can just take the negative log of this value, and we get 1.57 as the pH of the solution. Let's try one more. What is the pH of a 0.1 molar aqueous solution of hypochlorous acid, or HOCl, which has a Ka of 3.5 times 10 to the negative 8? Again, the more relevant equilibrium is that of hypochlorous acid, as this will produce much more hydronium than the autoionization of water, which has a Kw of 10 to the negative 14. So we can consider only this acid-base equilibrium. The ice box will be essentially identical to the previous example, except we now have 0.1 molar for the initial concentration of the acid, and we have a different Ka value as we are looking at a different acid. Because this Ka is even smaller, it is certainly the case that we can make the simplifying assumption that change in acid concentration will be negligible. So let's just make this 0.1. Multiplying both sides by 0.1 and then taking the square root will allow us to solve for x, which will be 5.9 times 10 to the negative 5. Taking the negative log, we get 4.23 as the pH of this solution. One useful parameter we can use to quantify the strength of a weak acid is its percent dissociation. This is equal to the concentration of dissociated species over the initial concentration of the acid times 100. So it is the fraction of the acid molecules that dissociate. For example, earlier we saw that in a 1 molar HF solution, the hydronium concentration is 0.027 molar. This represents the dissociation, so this value goes on top, over the initial concentration of 1, times 100, and we get 2.7%. This means that 2.7% of the acid molecules actually dissociate.
Understanding acid-base equilibria is critical for a number of other concepts, so this will be worth practicing. For now, let's check out some other acid-base concepts. Professor Dave for Chegg. See you next time.